Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. For this video, I'm going to be talking about and going over my toilet and hot shower tent that I use when truck camping. And I've gotten several requests to do a more detailed video about that, and I'm finally getting around to it. Apologize for the delay, but better late than never. With me today, I've got Boogie, and Boogie is in quite a few of my bird hunting videos. He will be turning 8 years old in a couple of months. And just yesterday, unfortunately, had a foot injury that he was in the vet's office quite a bit of the day yesterday and is on restricted activity. So I figured he could do this with me. He's going to have a full recovery though. And it is hot today, so the shade is important. Here is what I use for my hot shower tent. And one thing that is a consideration on the front end when kind of figuring this stuff out is how to keep things small, because space is limited for a truck camping setup, obviously. And so when I was coming up with different parts of this, I wanted it to be able to pack down pretty small. And I think this does. What I've got here is a 5 gallon bucket, and I use it for water when I'm actually taking a shower, but also I pack all the shower hardware in it and use that way. This is the toilet, and I use a bush toilet. It's called a bush toilet, and it folds out, but it has worked well for me, and it does pack down small. If it's very cold, I've got a little propane heater that I can put in there that works well to keep the tent really warm. And then that back there is the tent itself. Over here are a couple additional things that I need for this, but that I use for other parts. It's not specific. These aren't specific for the hot shower tent. I need an electrical power source, which I use my Jackery for that. And then a water jug, of course, for the water that I use in the shower. All right, let's get started with the tent. The tent is a Jolka brand, and also the pump and the shower head that I use came with this tent. They also sell a water heating system that uses propane, and I elected not to go with that myself, but it probably works very well. So let me go ahead and open this up. I have not opened this up since the last time I used it, so I'm not sure exactly what I'll find. Here are tent stakes. One feature of this tent that I liked is that it's all one piece. So there are no tent poles to put together or anything like that. Let's see if I can kind of remember this. This is the back of the tent, so let me turn it around. All right. I said it's been a while since I've done this, so I'm a little clumsy with it. Now, so I got two more parts here, two more steps. And that's it. That's a quick setup, I think. And it's hot out here, so I'm sweating, excuse that. But anyway, so that's how quick it is. Of course, if I was going to be setting it up more permanently, I'd go ahead and put the tent stakes in, stretch it out a little bit further so that it would be more secure. Okay, so looking at this on the inside in a little more detail, here's the opening to the door. The way I use this right side as the bathroom. And you can see I've got some TP there actually left over. Here's something that you can use to put shower stuff in, or I also hang my clothes up on this, or a towel, and there's another pocket down there for that. And then over here, and there is a door that you can put up on the inside here to separate the shower and the bathroom parts if you want to. But this is the shower component, and I'll get in here in a minute. There are windows that you can open if that's something that you need. And I do actually open those some when I put the propane heater in there just for ventilation. All right, so here's the toilet. I'll go ahead and, again, this is called a bush toilet. And the main reason I was interested in this type was because it does fold down so small. But it sets up very easily as well. And there it is, it's ready. Now you do put a bag in here. It came with some biodegradable bags. And I still have some of those left. And it says it's rated up to 200 pounds. I'm a little over 200 pounds and I have not had any problems with this at all. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this in here. Another thing that's important about this is that it does seal up tight enough that there is no odor that escapes. And so you're not in here kind of taking a shower with that as a problem. It is sealed tight enough that you don't have odor as an issue. Now for the shower setup itself. So we've got lots of tubing here. This is the shower head. And an important feature of this is that it has an on-off switch so that while I'm taking a shower, I can turn the water off and wash some and then turn the water back on to rinse off. And that's important in terms of not having to use as much water to take a shower as, you know, opposed to a shower head that has to run continuously. So whatever you do, find something that works that way. This is the water heater, which I'll go over in more detail a little later, and then the pump that is used for this. So I'm going to go ahead and get this set up some off camera and then come back. Okay, so I've taken just a few minutes to set some of this up. And so here's the bucket, and the water will go in here. And then this is the intake for the pump and the shower system. And it has a filter on it. So I always use water that I've brought with me in a jug usually. But if I found some fairly clean water in a stream or something, I probably would use it for a shower. I wouldn't drink it, but I would use it for a shower, especially given the filter. Okay, that runs to the pump, which is here. And the pump needs to be powered, but it can be powered with a 12-volt outlet like from a vehicle. And it has a very long cord, so you could stretch that quite a ways if you wanted to. And then from there is becomes the red tubing. And the red tubing, you can see here, there's a place to enter the red tubing in through a hole in the bottom there and run it up the side of the doorway. And then there's your shower head that you can take your shower over here with. Let me put some water in here and practice with this. Now, typically when I'm taking a shower, to take a good shower, I need 3 or 4 gallons of water. And that'll usually cover it. This is a 5-gallon bucket. I'm going to go ahead and just to demonstrate. Should do it right there. All right, now I'm going to heat the water. I'm going to take this out. And I showed you this earlier. This is the water heater. And I'd never seen one. It's an electric water heater. And I'd never seen one of these before. And I was talking with a friend, Eric Forrester, who has an excellent, outstanding upland bird channel by his name, Eric Forrester. And he told me about this. He truck camps also. And it's simpler, I think, than using the propane option. So let me plug this into the Jackery. Right, so it's got a thermostat on it there, or an indicator how warm you can make the temperature. I'm going to set it to 91. You don't have to go that warm, but you can make it higher or lower. And it's starting to warm up in my hand, so I'm just put that in the water. Now, the manufacturer that sold this, they were emphatic. They had a lot of instructions about don't ever put your hand in the water while it's in the water, because I think there is some risk of electrocution. So, and it's very tempting to just want to see how warm the water is, if it's about ready yet or not. In fact, they sold it with a thermometer, but that didn't work for very long. So I do use my hand to kind of judge the temperature of the water. But what I do, just to make sure, is that I don't electrocute myself, is I take it and I hold it off to the side so that the water is not dripping into the bucket still, and then I put my hand in there and it's still perfectly cold now. But anyway, then put it back in. So you can figure out the best way to do that for yourself. But anyway, this will take several minutes to warm up. So I'm gonna let that run for a bit. Let's see, how much is it drawing from the Jackery? Quite a bit of output, 1,252 watts, and it's 1,500, so it's almost at capacity for this, but you don't have to do it for very long. I'm going to check the water temperature now. It's been in there a little while, not too long. Again, I hold it off to the side. Oh yeah, it's quite a bit warmer now, so I'm going to go ahead and stop it there, and let me turn off the power and unplug that. So I'll move this off to the side. And I'll put the pump back in the water. And you want to put the pump receiver, whatever you're using for that, on the bottom of the bucket, so that you're using all the water instead of it kind of sitting up at an angle. Now we do need to power the pump, and I can use the Jackery for that also. Here's the 12 volt. Hopefully this will work. All right, now let's see what happens when I turn this on. All right, so now the water should be in here for the most part. It might need to run out a little bit more. Let me see what happens. Okay, so there you have it. Okay. And that's warm. It could be as warm as you want it to be. Turn it off and the pump stops. Okay, so there you go. That's pretty much how that works. And if it is cold, very cold, I've used this in the snow. I've got this back here. And have been fine in here. I will set this little propane heater up on the toilet, keeping it off of the sides, and then we'll use some kind of vent. There's a vent up here or this window so that it can keep it a little bit warmer in here. So there we go. That's it. So I'm going to turn the pump off. And you can see we didn't use any water there. So this is pretty simple. It's compact in terms of packing it down, and it's worked well for me. And again, like, I've used it in pretty extreme weather sometimes, and it's where I get the warmest is when I've got that heat on in there and you're using hot water for that. I don't usually use this unless I'm going to be somewhere for a couple of days. So for example, if I'm driving out to Oklahoma and I'm staying over at a rest area overnight or somewhere further in a couple nights, I don't set it up in a rest area. Then I'm just using the bathroom and public facilities. And if I need to take a shower, I'll take one at a truck stop or something like that. But if I'm going to be somewhere remote for several days or a couple days at least, I go ahead and set this up, and it makes makes camping much more comfortable than it would be without it. All right, thanks again. And let me know if you have any questions.